Here's the first one.
We want to say a few words about Director Mueller, what we learned from his testimony, and next steps in our work to hold President Trump accountable for his conduct. Robert Mueller is a man of honor and integrity. He has led a life defined by service to his country. Some have argued that because Director Mueller was reluctant to testify and seemed older than some remembered him, his work is somehow diminished. It is not.
Wait, you might think, well, I thought you said Mueller was going to say he is in the next bite here.
He showed that the Trump campaign both welcomed and benefited from this attack on our country. And he showed that the president repeatedly lied to cover it up. And if that were not enough, Director Mueller's testimony removed all doubt. He told us that Donald Trump obstructed justice and abused his office by tampering with witnesses, attempting to block the investigation, and attempting to fire the special counsel.
Right. So, of course, there wasn't any collusion. None of this happened. The investigation was not impeded. The investigation was not shortened by any stretch of the imagination. So they just go out and continue to try to restart. Now, they're able to do this, as we all know, because the drive-by media is going to amplify. The drive-by media is going to echo. The drive-by media is not going to embarrass them. The drive-by media is, what are you talking about, Jerry? We all watched this yesterday. You're full of it. The drive-by media is not going to do that. So they've got their narrative, and no matter what reality does to intercede, they are going to continue on it. In the process, folks, they look like fools. They may look like heroes to their base, but they look like abject fools. And they apparently have no compassion. Now, let me go back to yesterday's program. Because I was watching cable news here during the breaks, and I saw yet another segment on all of the devastation the Russians committed in the 2016 election. All of the meddling, all of the damage. And I've gotten fed up with this now. There wasn't any Russian meddling in the election any more than Russian meddles in America. Is attempting to meddle, just like we try to meddle. Barack Obama tried to influence the outcome of Israeli elections. He didn't want Netanyahu to win. None of this is out of the ordinary. It is the way an adversarial world works. The United States is a great nation at risk in a dangerous